Ready?
I'm ready.
Okay. So first question is, Korea seems like a familiar destination to you.
Sure, I think it's my fourth time.
So what did you do before you coming to this party?
I essentially did a day of interviews like this. I'm being completely honest with you, which is my tendency.
So the second one, Korea's response to Urban Decay's pretty different campaign was really good.
Okay.
So we wanna know what makes you pretty different.
Well, I think the idea is begging to defer, you know? We defer when it comes to societal norms, the status quo, these theoretical, aspirational models of what we're supposed to be. Mm-hmm. If you can strike the word supposed from your language and should, if you can just strike that from the way that you think and feel, then you're starting to gravitate closer to what we think as global citizens. People should find their own means of translating the beauty that they experience in the world through their physical form and into the hearts and minds of other people. So the whole idea of being pretty different is finding a different model for what it means to be pretty. Mm-hmm. One that is more of a highlight on our internal reality than some supposed cookie cutter model of what we should look like. Because again, the word should in that context is just ridiculous. There's no way you're supposed to look. There's no way you should be. What's valuable to us as global citizens for the Urban Decay's Pretty Different campaign is who you are.
Yeah.
We are not to be limited in a little box in a social media post, trying to conform to someone else's vision of what beauty is.
True, I totally agree with that. I really like your answer. Okay, the third question is, when did you first realize you were different or unique from everyone else?
It's a knowledge I've held my entire life. I was a very, very strange child, so there was really not much running from.
Okay, were you suffering from like knowing you were a little bit different from anyone else, or?
Suffering is a part of how you know you're alive.
True.
I think, you know, it's the first noble truth, right? That life is suffering. And I've certainly known my share of suffering. And some of that has surely been because I couldn't easily fit myself into a manufactured model of what people are. I think that there's a lot of suffering available to all beings, and I think instead of trying to get out of it, we can try to get into it, right?
Yeah.
Get into suffering, because it's a part of living, and it's actually a part of living that brings us closer to the true godly principle, you know, beyond the other option, which is detachment. And so I say, suffer. Feel the pain, experience it, and relish the experience of it, because it means that you are blessed with this gift of life. So yeah, I suffered, and I wouldn't trade a drop of that suffering for a world of normality.
Cool. Okay, so next question is going to be, many people, regardless of their age, suffer from the process of accepting the differentiation they have from others. So can you tell us any advice that you have from your experience? I think you already say that.
Yeah, but I can reiterate it, because I think it's so important.
It is.
I remember so much being a young person and wanting so badly to get out of the pain that I felt all the time in such a deep, constant, undeniable way. And what really changed it for me is this realization of, instead of getting out of it, getting into it. Get into discomfort, get into suffering, get into pain, ground yourself in that reality, use it as the conscious fuel to the fire of the creation you will bring to this earth if you're active and awake.
So you mean, like, if you feel a little different or unique from everyone else, you have to take the suffer, right? Like, because that's like part of
I'd take it out of a language of you have to do anything, though, because the you have to do is the same as you should do, you're supposed to do, and you're supposed to be, and you have to be. And this is what everyone's going to tell you as you're growing up and coming into consciousness in the world, is you should be this, you're supposed to do this, you have to be that. And you know what? They're full of shit. It's not true. You don't have to be anything. There's no requirements in this life. There's only opportunity. Opportunity to realize your true nature, opportunity to not realize your true nature, and detach and go further and further from it. Like, all of these opportunities are given you, you know? I think on a quintessential level, and quintessential is one of my favorite words because it means the five elements,
mm-hmm.
right? The five essences, like yeah. like quintuplets, yeah. right? Would be five twins. The quintessential. What is your quintessential being? Find that. Give us that. We want that. We need that. We're out of time on planet Earth. You know what I mean? We've disregarded the five elements for too long, you know, and it's really turning on us. We're in a, this is, at this point, you know, we talk about a beauty campaign, but for me, this is a really, really important conversation mm-hmm. here at what could be the end of days.
It is.
In terms of what are we? What are we actually?
Mm-hmm.
And what can we be to each other? And how can we live in harmony with one another and with all being on the earth? Can we or can we not is a big question too. Do we choose pain, which is the pain of doing the work to try to remedy the situation we're in,
mm-hmm.
or do we continue to detach and disconnect and get deeper and deeper into our cell phones and get further and further away from that essence of who we are
mm-hmm.
As the world ends around us?
The theme of today's party is stay naked. What does that mean to you?
It means totally what I'm talking about, right? Stay naked, remain in the expression of your absolute inherent being. Do not add these additional layers of facade, of mm-hmm. disguise. Take those layers away, and when you've taken them away, remain in that really, really primordial place. That primeval forest of your true nature, of your true being. So I like the campaign a lot, and I like the name a lot, and I identify with it for those reasons, you know. Cosmopolitan,
yeah.
keyword.
Can you give us your definition of fun, Phyllis, female?
Sure. So fun, the temporal state of enjoyment. In enjoyment or joy, but that happened, that burns up in the fuel of life. I have a lot of fun really with the simplest things in life, what we might call the primitive natures. Working, which I'm doing right now, self-preservation. Sex is fun. Sleeping I find really fun. Eating is fun. Those are the four primitive natures. Self-preservation, eating, sex, and sleeping. And then on top of that, it's really endless. You know, for me, creativity and engaging in making things, particularly with people whom I love, is fun. Fearless, without the restrictive element that is fear, that is here to really moderate how far we go in life, is according to how much fear we hold. So fearless is stripping away that restrictive barrier. And female I see as half of the gender manifestations of the singular, genderless, divine, unified being that is everything all put into one. One side of that expression is female or feminine energy.
So, can you please say hello, Cosmo? This is like great to camera.
Hi, Cosmo. I am Cookie. Some people call me Ezra. Some people call me Little Baby or Sweet Bitch. This is great. I'm having fun. I'm fearless. Feeling pretty female.
Done. Thanks for the interview.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh, you look amazing.
Yeah, you look amazing too.
Thank you. How did you? Did you do it? Do you understand?
Yeah.
알아듣겠어요?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, 진짜요? 한국말로 할까요?
You need a stay naked campaign. That's what I'm getting.
Yeah, true. So. Oh, you look amazing.
Yeah, you look amazing too.
Thank you. How did you? Did you do it?
Did you do your makeup?
It was a collaborative effort. Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Did you come up with that idea?
Yeah, this happened very spontaneously because we were thinking, should we sell our gold? And then someone said, do you want to try? And I was like, yeah, that's a great idea.
So, would you mind doing a quick selfie?
I don't at all mind.
I'm a huge fan.
Oh, well, thank you.
That's a good question. Thank you so much.
Sure.